हेलो चिल्ड्रन, हाय, दिस इज़ कामेश्वरी, सोशल टीचर. चिल्ड्रन, द लास्ट क्लास आई स्टार्टेड द लेसन दैट ऑन द ट्रायल ऑफ द अर्लीस्ट पीपल. इन दैट वीडियो वी लर्नड हंटर गैदरर्स मीनिंग, व्हाई डिड दे मूव फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू प्लेस, एंड वेयर डिड द आर्कियोलॉजिस्ट्स फाउंड द सोर्सेस ऑफ दोज हंटर गैदरर्स. We discussed in the last class. Now in this video, we discuss how did they prepare tools, how did they hunt the animals, how did they use the fire, what were the hobbies of those people. Okay, children. Now let's get started the lesson, the trial of the earliest people. Making stone tools. How did they hunt animals in those days? Guns are not available, any tools are not available to them, only stone tools are available. How did they made these stone tools? Archaeologists said that they used two different techniques. First one is stone on stone, second one is pressure flaking. Now we discuss stone on stone. Here, the pebble from which the tool was to be made was held in one hand. Suppose I am preparing one stool with one rock. Okay, you feel it is a rock. That rock I put in one hand. Another stone which was used as hammer, that another rock used as a hammer was held on the other hand. That is in other hand, the stone. The second stone was used to strike off flakes from the first till the required shape was obtained. How much time I used that it is the stone, the spelling mistake is there, that is not stoned second. Okay, children, now that is about stone to stone. They are using two stones. One stone they are taking in one hand, another stone is taking in another hand. They are striking. At last, up to require the shape was obtained. That like that they prepared stone tools. That is the first technique of making stone tools. Next one is pressure flaking. The core was placed on firm surface. The hammer stone was used on a piece of bone or stone that was placed on the core to remove flakes that could be sharpened into tools. You see, that is here they centered on core and they are hitting in the same point. After that, that could be shaped into tools like this. This is the example of pressure flaking. Next, finding about the fire. In the early humans, they did not know about the fire. Unknowingly, those members observed one rock hit another rock. At that time, what happened? Little fire comes out of that rocks. They observed, oh, like that they invented the fire. After they used the fire in different types. How did our archaeologists know about the hunter gatherers fire? Is traces of ash have been found by the archaeologists in Karnool caves. Beside the Karnool caves, the traces of ash have been found by our archaeologists. That's why those people also know the fire, they said to us. This suggests that people were familiar with the use of fire. How did they use this fire? They used fire as a source of light to roast meat and scare away animals. They used fire as a source of light. Yes, it gives us light in the night time. And roasted meat. They roast meat in that fire and scare away animals. The fire is there, the in front of the caves, all the animals, they understood here some human beings are there. It is a dangerous place to them. That's why no animal did not come near to those areas like that and scare away animals. So early people used fire like that. A changing environment. Around 12,000 years ago, there were major changes in the climate of the world. 12,000 years ago, climate changed. How it changed? Temperature increased. Then what happened? Due to that, grasslands developed. When the grasslands developed, the number of grass-eating animals increased. Grass-eating animals all are came near to that grassland. They survive in the surrounding areas of those grasslands. Hunter-gatherers followed those animals, learning about their habits and their breeding seasons. This helped people to start thinking about herding and rearing these animals. Okay. Animals stayed in one areas. Hunter-gatherers followed those animals. Why did they follow those animals? Animals provided them meat, milk, and eggs, some of the things, food items to them. That's why the hunter-gatherers followed those animals. After that, they learned something from those animals. They learned what are the habits of those animals and their breeding seasons also they learned. After that, this helped the people to start thinking about herding and rearing these animals for themselves. Fishing also became important in this time. After that, this was also the time when several grain breeding grasses including wheat, barley and rice grew naturally in different parts of the subcontinent. At that time, so many areas were, some grasses are there including wheat, barley, rice are grow naturally grow. No one did not cultivate that land. Naturally grow these overall food crops in those areas. Men and women and children probably collected these all our grains as their food items. What is the duty of those people? Those people all are went into the forest and they're gathering the food items and bring back and eat. That is the duty of those people. That's why men and women, children, these all collected these grains as food and land where they grow and when they ripen. At the time, they observed in which areas these all crops grow, which lands are suitable to them. So, they started agriculture. And which season they ripen, which season they are ready to eat for them. They observed that thing at those days. This may have led them to think about growing plants in their own. Where they are, those people all are living in the surrounding areas, people started growing plants. After that, what are the works of the hunter-gatherers are eating, sleeping, hunting, fishing, these are the works. But in the leisure time, they drew paintings also. Early peoples lived in the caves. They used to draw paintings on the walls of caves. Which type of pictures they have drawn? Wild animals, goat, tiger, deer, whatever may be, this type of animals pictures they had drawn on the walls of caves. Archaeologists found these paintings in Madhya Pradesh and southern Uttar Pradesh. These wall paintings are found in our India, Madhya Pradesh and southern Uttar Pradesh. Who did what? In those days, both men and women had done many works together. All the members are doing all the works. Some tasks were done by women, some others only by men. More easy tasks were done by the women and difficult hunting, fetching the water to long distances, such type of works were done by the men. Ostrich's eggs were found in India. Where did they found? They found in Maharashtra state in Patna during the Paleolithic period. Okay, next, early people sites were found in Hunxi. The surrounding areas of Hunxi, archaeologists found the Paleolithic sites. The old stone age is called the Paleolithic age. That is about our Hunxi. In Hunxi area, people used the limestone. Okay, children. With this, I completed the second chapter. In the next video, I explain to you the keywords and the textual exercises. Okay, children. Bye.